Now let's talk about what we've done today in Coulomb's law. We talked about the electric field and how it was calculated from a 1 coulomb test charge, and that told us the force that that test charge was experiencing. We looked at Coulomb's law in the four forms: point, line, surface, volume, charge distributions, and those four are shown right here. In the case where you have point charges, you sum up all of the point charges divided by the distance squared, 4 pi epsilon, with the unit vector ri. If you had line charges, you took your line distribution, your linear distribution, multiplied it by the appropriate dl, and did the same thing, integrated it over a length. In the case of a surface charge distribution, you would multiply by ds and integrate over a surface. And in, of course, the case of a volume, you would multiply by dv, and you'd integrate over the volume. I want to make two notes here. One is, remember, there's an alternate form. Any time that you have a unit vector divided by a magnitude squared, that's equivalent to the vector, not the unit vector, but the vector divided by the magnitude cubed. Also, I've used RSP in this lecture because it makes more sense to me that that is a vector from the source to the point. But in previous lectures, like old exams, I've used RPS instead of RSP. So please don't think that these two things are opposite of each other. They're just different names. I'm trying to find an easy notation to use. Now, in the case that you have a rectangular coordinate system, the steps that you do are very simple. You define an origin. You write a vector RS from the origin to the source, which is your charge. You write a vector RP from the origin to the place that you want to find your field point. And then you find a vector from the source to that point. That's the RSP vector. You apply Coulomb's law, and you sum or integrate to find the electric field at that point. In case you had cylindrical or spherical, you did two additional steps. When you wanted to write your vector RS, the easiest thing to do is to convert the source point from cylindrical or spherical to XYZ coordinates using table 3-2. Then you could go about your steps the same until you came to the point where you're doing the integration. Then you would want to convert back to cylindrical or spherical if you wanted to find the electric field in that particular coordinate system. Again, you would use table 3-2 to do that. So I hope that now you're well prepared to go to your homework problems and be able to write equations for these electric fields. Now, one important thing is sometimes there are simplifications for a few simple cases that will let you do these analytical expressions, that will allow you to do analytical expressions instead of what appear to be the more complicated expressions I've shown you here. But in real life, most of the simple cases, all of the simple cases, have already been done. You'll find them in your book. So what I've shown you here works for generic cases that may be far from simple. You would use a computer to do the numerical integration. You wouldn't be doing that by hand.